Welcome back home again.
Oh, thank you so much.
What does it mean to you when you come back to Chicago?
Oh, it's the best. I mean, to me, it's truly home, and I get to see a bunch of my family, and I always feel at myself here.
So when you were going to Columbia College, where I graduated from also, by the way,
alums.
I am not on the cover of a magazine, though. This has got to make you feel pretty cool.
Yeah, it's totally bizarre and surreal, but super nice, and especially in Chicago, which is where I really started doing comedy, so it makes sense.
Talk a little about your history.
Yeah, I mean, I truly started taking classes at I.O. and The Annoyance and, worked at Second City for years, and that's where I got found it by SNL. So it's really, I don't know, it's a special place to me forever, yeah. And I feel like it's where I found my comedic voice, so yeah.
So these days, being on SNL has got to be amazing, but it also puts you into a unique political spotlight.
Yeah.
Also, maybe more so than ever in the history of Saturday Night Live.
Sure.
Is that a good thing?
Yeah, I mean, I think SNL has always been something that, you know, grapples with pop culture and politics and what's happening today, this week, tomorrow. And so, thankfully, I'm not usually tasked with being the one to write those things. I get to just kind of sail on through and do silly stuff in the middle. But yeah, I'm super proud of the work the show has done.
What's been some of your favorite things that you've done?
Oh my gosh, how do I choose? I love the all-girl music videos I've done with the other ladies in the cast, and I've done a lot of sketches with Kate that I really have loved. We just did the past couple shows that have been really fun, so I can't choose, I don't know.
Yeah, it's like asking, what's your favorite kid, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Everybody is talking about Shrill in a great way. In a great and powerful way. You must be so proud of this.
I mean, certainly. I'm so happy to finally have it out. We've been working on it for a long time, and it's a lot of our heart and soul is in there. So the fact that people are responding to it means so much, yeah.
Yeah, what was your sort of your creative driving force? What was the message that you were trying to tell? What is it that you're trying to do with the show?
You know, I don't know if there was like one driving message. I think we wanted to create a really full character and show their full life and allow the audience to have empathy and feel for that person, and especially someone who isn't typically the center hero of the story, a fat woman who often would be relegated to the friend character and those kinds of things, which I've done happily before, and it's like a very special experience to get to step into the center and write and produce and help make it. So.
Just since we've been talking about that you were going to be on today, people have been talking about the show and how it moves them, how it makes them laugh, but also brings them to tears at how empowering it is, and as though you are hearing their thoughts and putting their thoughts up on the screen.
Well, that's very nice and super overwhelming.
The power that you have.
I have so much power. I'm about to take this mic out of your hands. it's so nice, and that's absolutely like what we hope to do. I mean, I think Lindy's story and my story and a lot of our writers in the writer's room, there was so much overlap there, and so we understood that there was like a universal experience that maybe hadn't been tapped into in this way with this kind of time and energy. So, yeah, we're super happy.
Yeah, and it really sort of ties into all the talk these days about bullying and people being made to feel isolated if they are too tall, too short,
sure,
too skinny, too fat, whatever, those things.
Yeah, I mean, I think these are all ideas that people are really starting to think about, and about how judgments and assertions that you make about other people, maybe it's not your place, and I think that's what we were trying to get at, yeah.
So what's next? What's going to be going on? You're loving Saturday Night Live? You love being there all the time?
Oh, yeah. I love SNL. I'm not ready to go. I just made this whole damn other show, so what's next? I hope a vacation
or something.
You speak of it
so lovingly.
Yeah.
But movies? I have to think. I mean, in that Amy Schumer movie not
long
ago.
Yeah, maybe. My schedule is very bad because I work at SNL full time and I write, produce, and star in Shrill now. And if I could squeeze a movie in there or maybe just a vacation is really the thing I want the most.
Great.
Yeah.
You probably won't have time while you're here, but if there's one Chicago place where you could go eat tonight, what would that be?
Oh, tough to pick. I have a lot of favorites, but I love Handlebar in Wicker Park, one of my faves. So, yeah.
Good deal.
Yeah.
You don't know how close you came to me bringing you pizza.
Oh, I could get into that too. Thank you so much. Nice to see you too.
Thanks for having me.